Hello Simmers, I'm shaking up my video release schedule a bit. Yeah, that's a joke, because if you follow the channel, you know I'm super behind my September videos. But anyway, let's dive into the long-awaited Boeing 707-320C from Aeroplane Heaven, available in the marketplace for 15 euros or 10 if you have the premium deluxe edition of Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Let's not beat around the bush, you've probably already heard about it, but honestly, the release of the Boeing 707 is a disappointment in several ways. Not everything is bad though, so let's take a closer look. The graphics are mixed, you can't say it's ugly, but you can't call it beautiful either. The textures are decent, there are lots of details and you get both a passenger and a cargo version. However, there's a lack of polish in many areas, rough textures, poor rendering of the cockpit windows, and poor window animation, by the way, that look very arcadey or unfinished. Minor issues with the 3D model, etc., etc. When you add all this up, it just doesn't scream quality. The cabin is not accessible in cockpit view, by the way, and you have to switch to the drone view if you want to have a look here. And I'll leave you for a minute just to have a look of the plane, and if you don't want to have a look, you can jump right to the next chapter. This part is a complete disaster, let's be honest. I'm not blaming anyone, we know there are constraints for the release of Famous Flyer, but the specs needs to be revised because this is unacceptable. On the one hand, Flight Simulator can offer us an excellent A320 V2 for free, and on the other, we get a paid Famous Flyer that's totally subpar. It's inconsistent and gives the entire sim a bad image. It feels like you're flying inside a vacuum cleaner, and again, it's just not acceptable. I've said it many times, I try to stay humble when talking about flight models or physics, because I'm neither an engineer nor a pilot, but I do have a bit of experience in Flight Simulator since I've had the chance to try almost every available plane in the sim. I can definitely compare the differences and the similarities between two airliners, and clearly this one is far from giving you the same sensation you get from other planes in the same category or era. Very far. This for me is the biggest flaw of this add-on. I can do loops and quick maneuvers without any consequences, which just doesn't make sense. The good news is I think it could be fixed pretty quickly. Also, a note on the user experience, because some button and switch are a bit difficult to click on and it can be annoying. However, when it comes to the systems, it's a pleasant surprise. It's not super complex, but it's not meant to, but it's enough to immerse you in that era, and you are well guided by the interactive checklist in the sim. As I said at the beginning, it's a disappointment, mostly because there was a lot of hype surrounding the plane, and rightly so, but probably too much for a plane in the famous flyer category. Personally, the main issue is the flight dynamics. You really don't feel like you're flying a Boeing 707. Yes, I know, that's a highly subjective view, but still. Once these issues are fixed, it will be okay. It will be a passable plane, but it will never be the one you hesitate to pick in your hangar. If you're scrolling through your list of planes and can't decide which one to fly, the 707 definitely won't be on your shortlist. Hopefully, a major patch comes soon to fix all this. And that's it for today, guys. I hope this short video was informative enough to give you an idea, and I'll see you soon on the channel. Ciao!